Welcome in to Talk of the Town with Henry Hinton.
Everyone, why are we all standing around? Let's go.
News, weather, sports, and of course, all the local info you need to start your day.
You read my news!
This is Talk of the Town with Henry Hinton.
Please tell me this is some kind of sick, tasteless joke.
On 103.7 WTIB, 94.1 WNBU, Cable 7 in Greenville, and now, listen or watch live at WTIBFM.com. Now, here's your host for Talk of the Town.
I thought you were kidding!
Henry Hinton.
Hey. Hey.
Hi.
Welcome. You remember Rerun too, huh?
A little bit.
Hey. Mm-hmm. My wife does that all the time. 5 minutes after 8, welcome back to Talk of the Town, second hour here Monday morning, March 6th. Good to have you with us this morning. Trent McGee in the studio, along with Matt Engelbrecht from WITN, Michael Buscemi, and Mark Rizzo back, both of them in the control room. On the other side of the game. Good to see you both at the home show on Saturday. Thank you both for coming out and helping.
It was fun.
Michael was out there. By the way, Michael, did you get your peanuts?
I did not.
I'm trying to remember his name.
I love peanuts.
Mr. Ely from up in Harrellsville, McGee, brought us an entire bag of peanuts. And he wanted to make sure, and they're in the, I think they're in the van.
I'll get them after the show.
He said you asked for them.
I did.
He said when he called in and got qualified to win the cruise that you had a conversation with him about peanuts or something.
Oh, yeah. I do remember that.
So he brought you like a, look, when I'm talking about a bag of peanuts, I'm not talking about like a 2 or 3 pound bag of peanuts. I'm talking about like a 100 pound bag of peanuts.
Holy moly. Wow.
It's probably not 100 pounds, but it's like one of those old 100-pound feed bags
that I used to drag
around. And, McGee, he wanted especially because he knows your dad is your dad's the big Hampton Farms guy, right?
Mm-hmm.
So this is – he says we're competitors with McGee's dad. Make sure McGee gets some of these peanuts.
Mm-hmm. There we go.
McGee's dad
I love all kinds of peanuts.
Yeah.
I don't have a preference.
Yeah. And let me tell you something. If they were grown up in northeastern North Carolina, they're going to be good.
Exactly right.
Best peanut soil in the country, right there.
And you can't watch a baseball game without peanuts.
Exactly.
It's one of those things.
But thanks to you guys for coming out. Congratulations again to Scott Byram, who won the 7-day Alaskan cruise. And thanks to all of our exhibitors. I was talking to folks. It looked like one of the best turn. I think the numbers showed that we were up like 200 people from last year. So I don't know what the difference was, but it was a really good day. And I talked to all the exhibitors, and it seemed like people were interested in buying things and remodeling their homes and stuff. So maybe the economy is such that the home show this year, all the vendors really said they did well with it. There were two or three booths that, people were 5-6 deep every time you went by there.
Everybody we talked to Friday morning before the show said that, they were having good seasons, good years, or good starts to the year in preparation for spring. So
yeah,
I think it's a great sign.
That was encouraging. All right, 8 minutes after. We were just talking about the weather during the news break, and today it's going to be 64. Tomorrow it's going to be 72. And so I have assumed, Engelbrecht.
Mm-hmm.
I have assumed that spring is here.
Okay.
But you just burst my bubble during the news break because you said we have some cold weather still coming.
No, I was just asking Trent, in order for it to be spring, would that mean from here on out we have no freezing temperatures? Is that, or can we have a couple of...
and of course it's very cold this morning. It was below 30, it was below 32 this morning. I think 30 degrees when we got here.
Yeah. Yeah. I would say what happened this weekend, we have probably maybe... two more events like that for the month of March. Or it's not going to be an entire week that it's going to be cold. It'll be a few days here.
What's
there.
The first official day of spring? March 21st?
20th.
20th.
Mm-hmm.
So we're getting close. I mean, today's the 6th. But we just have had a very mild winter.
Very.
That proves two things. Number one, the groundhog doesn't know what he's talking about, and there is global warming. And, I'm okay with global warming. Keep on warming it up. I don't, pretty soon we'll all be living like we're living in Florida or something. Mm-hmm.
I can deal with it.
But does the fact that we had such an incredibly warm winter, Matt, mean that we're going to have a we're going to all roast this summer?
No, actually, there's no correlation. Charlie Ironmonger, our other meteorologist, I had him look into that a couple weeks ago. And it's almost 50-50. Some years, some summers were warmer than average. Other summers were below average, depending on what we do in the winter.
Mm-hmm. Interesting.
Mm-hmm.
But it is going to be warm the rest of this week, isn't it?
Yeah, it looks good. Rest of this week, and the pattern looks like it's going to change a little bit for a couple of days around the 11th. 10th, yeah. 11th.
So. Good, good.
And we spring forward Sunday. So.
Yes.
Oh, that's right. Daylight savings time comes in on Sunday, Saturday night.
Mm-hmm.
Sunday morning, 2 a.m. So the days will get – you know what that means, though? Because this morning I was driving to work just thinking, man, it's really nice to have the sun up while we're coming to work. But in all honesty, I'd give that up for longer afternoons.
I would, too.
Because, you know, you can always get a nine holes in.
Exactly.
Right. And I was at a Greenville Country Club this weekend, McGee, and the greens are perfect. They're absolutely perfect already. But and you know what else? You know what else? I'm going to. I talked to Mike Skinner at the home show, our buddy from the strawberry field here, the biggest strawberry field in Pitt County. Mm-hmm. Strawberries on 903, and he said that the crop is going to be early this year. And so I'm wondering, with the crops and all that, we've had such warm weather, it's probably really induced a lot of good growth with some of the strawberries and stuff like that. But then you get these nights like last night. I mean, is that harmful to them?
Yeah, they were talking on Friday. We interviewed, I think it was Onslow County, either Onslow or Duplin County, a strawberry farmer down there. And they could lose their entire crop if they don't protect them. Yeah.
So how do they protect them?
One of two ways. I know one way is obviously to cover them. The other one is actually to put water on them. So they freeze and then they can thaw. I don't know the entire process, but it's
so you make them freeze on purpose.
Yeah, it's something like that because it helps preserve them, and then
wow.
And when they thaw out, they're fine. I don't know. I'm not a strawberry farmer. You can ask.
Well,
ask
Mike said everything's on looking good, but he said that the strawberries will be ready this year probably 2 weeks early.
That makes sense.
Which means that there's going to be 2 weeks. You know, you need to get your strawberries earlier. And, in fact, I'm going to call him this week and talk about when he wants to get his advertising started because, to be completely honest with you, he says it's going to might be a shorter season this year. So we'll see. All right, you know, we talked about the obvious fact that Trump was wiretapped last hour. I'm just kidding. For those of you who got very upset with me, I got some emails and some texts like, you're an idiot. You believe that Trump really was wiretapped. I do believe it, by the way, but hey, we'll just wait and see. Everybody said that Nixon was not involved. Everybody said it. We'll see. Let's get to some state politics. You know, all the hubbub about the Senate wanting to confirm the top people in the Cooper administration, like they do at the federal level. Did you see who Roy Cooper named last week as head of the ABC Commission? Did you guys see this?
I did, yep.
So Jim Gardner, who's the former lieutenant governor and a great Eastern North Carolinian, was the ABC commissioner under Pat McCrory. Now, let me tell you, there are only a few of these appointments outside of the cabinet positions that pay good money. The ABC board, I believe, all gets paid. Like the board I'm on, the university board, you not only don't get paid, it costs you money to be on this board. I'm totally serious. I think our per diem is don't laugh when I tell you this. They're talking about raising the per diem for the legislators from $102 a day to like $145 a day, which I think they should. The per diem for being on the Board of Governors is $15 a day.
Get you a sandwich and a sweet tea.
I don't even turn it in. I mean, it's just not worth it. So, because you got to fill the paperwork out.
That's just test.
I turn in my hotel expenses, and they don't even pay all of your hotel. I mean, if you stayed at a flea bag, they might. But
yeah.
It's crazy. So the ABC commission job is one of these jobs that pays pretty good money. So Roy Cooper, over the weekend, announced his pick to be the new chairman of the North Carolina Alcohol Beverage Control Commission, the ABC board. And he is a convicted felon. I kid you not. I kid you not. But hey, it's the second time he's been appointed. He announced that Xander Guy, and for those of you who listen to us down around Jacksonville, you know exactly who I'm talking about, because he used to be the mayor of Jacksonville. He is currently, or at least he was until Saturday, the mayor of Surf City. So he's been mayor of two towns. He will make $113,456 a year as chairman of the ABC board. He served as mayor of Surf City since 1999, which, of course, is a beach town at the center of Topsail Island in Pender County. He served as ABC commission member during Bev Perdue's administration. And all I can say is he must be a great fundraiser for the Democrats, for them to take the heat, because the guy is also a convicted felon. In 1990, he served 3 months in prison on a conviction for fraudulently billing clients of his insurance agency nearly $16,000. He was serving a three-year sentence when he got his sentence was commuted by Republican Governor Jim Martin. And so this guy is a convicted felon, or as the News and Observer likes to call him this morning, once a convicted felon. Let me ask you a question. Once you're a convicted felon, aren't you always a convicted felon? So that is your new ABC commissioner, and congratulations to Roy Cooper on that pick. Can't make it up. And by the way, I do not believe, since he's not a cabinet secretary, I do not believe he has to be confirmed by the Senate. So he's already started working. There was a ruling on Friday by a three-judge federal judge panel regarding the North Carolina lawsuits on redistricting. A panel of three federal judges issued a ruling Friday rejecting the request by North Carolina legislature to dismiss the cases last year filed by the groups that are trying to get the redistricting maps thrown out. The two groups that actually filed the deal were the League of Women Voters of North Carolina and a group called Common Cause, which is run by Bob Hall, who's a big liberal in Chapel Hill. Those two organizations have been critical, saying that, oh, my goodness, the districts look as though they've been gerrymandered. Oh, my God. They've gerrymandered the districts. This has never happened in North Carolina before. We got to sue them for it. Of course, that's how the Democrats stayed in power for 100 years, and they admitted it. They gerrymandered also. But the federal judges were James Wynn of the Fourth Circuit, of course, U.S. District Judges William Osteen and W. Earl Britt, all of the Fourth Circuit Court of Appeals. This is the liberal court in Richmond now. They noted the novelty of the arguments put forward in the cases challenging the maps and approved the Republican-led legislature in 2016, but they also noted obstacles the plaintiffs must overcome to prevail. So here you have a court that approved these districts who are now saying, you know, because you're being sued, you know, we're going to let the cases go forward. But we did approve them earlier. But, hey, we might have made a mistake. It's possible that we were operating on the basis of the ceiling is the roof.
Which Matt and I were still trying to figure out and make sense of. During the last break,
if you missed that, what do you think he meant?
Well, the ceiling is the roof, but I think he.
The ceiling's the roof. This is the ceiling inside. The roof's outside.
The ceiling is the point you're trying to. I don't freaking know.
So if you missed that last hour, this was Michael Jordan Saturday night at halftime of the Carolina Duke game.
I wish you guys nothing but best The ceiling is the roof. Let's make it happen.
I think it's
the ceiling is the roof.
Carolina football's new theme, their new mantra. You know, Carolina football, the ceiling is the roof. They're going to run out to it.
It might have been on the back of his shirt.
On the back
know.
Of their T-shirts now.
You think that should be the new logo at Carolina? The ceiling is the roof?
Have like a silhouette of Michael Jordan on top of some sort of roof. there's no roof at
Well, let's analyze this. I mean, is the ceiling the roof? And if the ceiling is the roof, why would you use that as a motivational speech?
Yeah, I don't think the roof.
Didn't he mean something like the sky is the limit?
That's what we're trying to figure out.
You know, he meant the sky is the limit. He probably meant something like we're going to burst through the ceiling and the roof.
Yeah,
to get to higher ground.
Yeah,
to get to a higher plane.
I bet MJ though has some pretty high ceilings. Let's be honest. You know, his house probably 14, 16 feet.
Maybe that's the thing.
Yeah.
Because his ceilings are so high, he thinks that's the desirable plateau.
Well, you guys don't have 16-foot roof?
I wish you guys nothing but best. The ceiling is the roof. Let's make it happen.
Hey, it gives you something to ponder all day. You can ponder that all day long.
I've been thinking about it a lot over the weekend, and I've been thinking, you know, my problem is I thought – that the ceiling wasn't the roof. Because I thought the ceiling was right here, right above us, and then the roof was outside. And so I've had it wrong all these years.
The roof is above the ceiling.
But Michael Jordan has now said the ceiling is the roof, so I had it wrong.
You did. Don't argue the point.
It's not on you.
Don't argue the point.
The ceiling is the roof.
It'll be one of those great quotes that students are asked years from now. Who once said the ceiling is the roof?
That should be a question.
It'll
on
be a Jeopardy.
Jeopardy
question. Yeah,
Alex Trebek. Let's go to crazy slogans for 30. This former NBA and basketball star once said, "The ceiling is the roof." McGee, you're in.
Jerry West.
What, you didn't say what is who what was. Is,
who was.
You have to say who was Michael Jordan. Yeah. Not or who is Michael Jordan.
Oh,
it would be better if they ask it this way. What was Michael Jordan's most famous line? What is the ceiling is the roof?
And it will now go down as his most famous line.
Okay, so there was a bill filed last week in the legislature. You know, we had these protesters blocking I-85, you know, after Trump was elected. You remember that between, I think it was between Greensboro and Burlington, they went out and blocked I-85. And John Torbett, who is a Gaston County House of Representatives member, sponsored House Bill 249. He says drivers who came upon protesters last fall feared for their lives, and his bill would add a little bit more of a deterrent by heightening awareness and adding a penalty. So now, if this bill passes, if you are a protester and you damage property or block traffic, it is going to be called economic terrorism. Good for Representative Torbett. It will now be a criminal offense if you block traffic as a protester. And I love it.
And something's got to be done. I mean, you can't do that. That's just.
North Carolina is one of 17 states where Republican lawmakers have filed bills addressing recent protests, according to the New York Times. Some of the proposals are similar to Representative Torbett's North Carolina legislation. If Torbett's bill passes, people who block roads while participating in a riot or an other unlawful assembly will face Class A1 misdemeanor charges, the misdemeanor category with the longest sentences for jail, probation, or community service. Illegally blocking roads for any other reason would remain a Class 2 misdemeanor. I'm disappointed it's not a felony.
It's just... And speaking, you're risking your own life by doing that. Well, I mean,
yeah. Speaking of I-85, have you guys picked up on this billboard?
Yes.
So there was a billboard, right, on I-85 between Winston-Salem and Greensboro. Or it actually could have been on, was it on, it's actually on Interstate 40 Business. It's on that business interstate between Winston-Salem and Greensboro now. And the billboard said, real men provide, real women appreciate it. Now, I ask you, ladies in the audience, are you offended by that? Real men provide, real women appreciate it. And so a group of women were very upset about that. They called it sexist, misogynistic, and gender and anti-gender equality. And they were raising money on one of these GoFundMe pages to put up another billboard to offset this sexist billboard that said real men provide, real women appreciate it.
So sexist. It's the first thing I thought of when I saw it.
Well, I mean, in today's environment, that would be considered sexist by many.
I don't think it's sexist at all.
Well, then you agree with the billboard that just went up.
I don't think it's sexist.
Because they got this group that is doing this GoFundMe page, and they were going to put it before they could get their message up. The billboard came down, and this went up. Much ado about nothing. This is what it says. A social experiment that brought forth those so immersed in their own insecurity that in the mirror they could only see an angry victim of their incorrect interpretation of a silly billboard. Bless their hearts. So whoever put up the real
definitely
men
definitely a bless
provide,
your heart moment is what yes. that is.
So the people that put up the real men provide, you know, did a preemptive strike on the feminists before they could get there and told them that they were immersed in their own insecurities and they can only see in the mirror an angry victim of their incorrect interpretation of a silly billboard. I actually believe that. So what do you think of this billboard? Tavares, 561-8255, 561-8255. Good morning, Tavares.
Good morning, Henry. I like the billboard.
You did?
We need some men, you know, actually providing here in America for their families and for the women in their families.
Amen, bro.
And it just goes toward the women that might say, well, you're supposed to provide. You're supposed to say, thank you, husband. Thank you, husband. Now go back out there and you go get the world for me, you know, and you encourage that man.
There is something to be said for women that will provide for their man. I mean, if my wife will start providing.
Yeah. And I'm not saying that.
Actually, my wife has always worked, and so I'm joking. So, you know, boy, I just realized.
I agree with that. You're right.
I just put myself in the doghouse. But my wife would never be offended by that, I don't think.
No, my wife wouldn't either, because once I start working, then there's a problem. And once I stop providing, there's a problem. But
so the way you see it, Tavares, it's a message to the men that won't provide. You didn't see it as a sexist and an anti-feminist message.
It's a message to the men to get your butt up and make these women happy. That's what makes women happy. That's what providing, getting
I love
them
it.
Stuff.
They, I love it.
Women
All right,
like
man.
Stuff.
Thank you. Good to hear from you.
Yeah.
561-8255. Where are we going, Michael? Brent. Good morning, Brent. How are you?
Hello, Henry Hinton. This is Brent Bennett, the Brent Bennett. How are you, buddy?
The Brent Bennett. Good morning, sir.
My question is, it's not really a question, it's just an observation. If the women have a GoFundMe page, isn't somebody providing for them to have the billboard?
Touche! I mean, that's a great point. That's a great point.
You understand what I'm saying, right?
Yeah, yeah. Well, you know, unless, of course, George Soros is the only man providing.
Yeah, that's right.
Oh, my
which
God.
Is, which is highly possible.
Go Trump.
All right, Brent, thank you. I appreciate that. All right, there you go. That's actually a great point. So these women who are complaining that real men provide are asking real men to provide money so they can put a billboard up. Mm-hmm. That's a great point. 29 after. We'll be right back. Stay with us.
It's a new year, and we're going to bring you the best offers on new cars and trucks here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep. It's the Start Something New event, and all 2016 Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, and Ram vehicles must go. Lease a new Jeep Grand Cherokee for only $239 a month, or lease a new Ram truck for only $299 a month. And if you buy now, you'll get 20% off select Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, and Ram. East Carolina Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep.
Come see it.
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
U.S. Cellular put towers where most others don't, so people can schedule a chiropractor visit out here, or catch the game live way over here. Isn't that what you pay for? A stronger signal in the middle of anywhere.
Visit Real Wireless, your local U.S. Cellular authorized agent in Ahoskie, Williamston, and Windsor for the best deals in wireless and great service on a network that works in the middle of anywhere.
Refills.
My son's shot records.
My doctor's appointments.
My lab results.
My parents' care.
My chart.
Vidant My Chart.
Vidant My Chart is the secure online patient portal that lets you manage your health your way. Visit VidantMyChart.com or call 1-855-MyVidant to learn how you can sign up.
We're off to a great start to the year at the new Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram.
It's time for a new truck. Save up to $10,087 on select 2017 Ram 1500 Crew Cab trucks during Ram Truck Month. You can also save big with a Jeep Grand Cherokee lease. Drive a new Grand Cherokee for just $259 per month.
We're ready to serve you at the new Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram on Highway 264 and shop us online at WashingtonChrysler.com.
Top Dog Academy is Eastern North Carolina's complete dog training facility. Top Dog provides an excellent environment for dogs of all ages with training services and workweek daycare. Top Dog is located on Highway 43 South, just 4 miles from Bells Fork, and features a comfortable, healthy environment and a spacious facility for daycare and a brand new, beautiful facility for training. Call 752-8215 or visit topdogonline.com.
Come on out Highway 43 South to Top Dog Academy, where we know dogs.
A32 coming up, news and sports with Engelbrecht and McGee here, and a lot to talk about in sports this morning. Big Pirate weekend for the baseball team. By the way, speaking of sports, that sounded like Howard Cosell. Didn't you remember Howard Cosell? Speaking of sports. Howard Cosell, speaking of sports. Our sports station, 94.3 The Game, this morning has kicked off a new lineup. We have Clay Travis on in the mornings.
Outkick the coverage,
which Clay Travis has become a big name in sports talk. So they put him on Fox Sports, so we have picked that up. But this afternoon at 3 o'clock is the debut here on 94.3 The Game of The Herd with Colin Cowherd. Arguably the probably second biggest name in sports talk radio behind Dan Patrick, which, of course, is still on from 9 to noon on 94.3 The Game. And then David Glenn from noon to 3. Colin Cowherd, The Herd with Colin Cowherd, debuts this afternoon on 94.3 The Game at 3 o'clock. I'm going to listen in. Maybe he'll mention us. Think he'll mention us?
Maybe.
And maybe so. And then, of course, as always, Josh Graham, 5 to 7 every day. 8:34. Before we go to news, of course, we were talking about Michael Jordan's assertion that we had not heard before Saturday night that the ceiling is the roof. Apparently, was it the EC? Was it the UNC Chapel Hill Alumni Association? Who was it that put?
No, it was the university.
The university themselves posted.
Yeah.
One of those 360-degree cameras from the Dean Dome?
Yep.
Yeah, so tell us about
Yeah, so it was an actual post, UNC, at Chapel Hill. And they say in the picture, the caption is, we hung a 360-degree camera from the ceiling. Then in parentheses, they say, or was it the roof? Which is directly in line with
the
what
university
Michael Jordan
said that.
Yeah, yeah. This
it's is funny because it's looking there. Down. Yeah,
and Michael Jordan had this response. The ceiling is the roof. He said, of course, the ceiling is the roof.
Yeah.
See, now it's confused everyone.
But I mean, all these people in Chapel Hill to claim to have all these intellectual qualities.
There'll be a committee put together.
They were not sure whether the ceiling was the roof, and then Michael Jordan straightened them out. He was
in. Guys, nothing but best. The ceiling is the roof. Let's make it happen.
Let's make it happen. Let's make the ceiling the roof.
There'll be a committee on this.
All right. Eighth. I think this should go to the law school for an interpretation. Mm-hmm. I think the UNC Law School should weigh in on whether or not the ceiling is the roof. There should be some litigation from the Poverty Center.
That's right.
Here is our news update. Matt Engelbrecht at our news desk from WITN this morning. Good morning, Matty.
Good morning. Yeah, starting off right. Time now, 8:36 on this Monday morning. Double check that weather forecast for you in a second. First, latest news headlines from WITN, WITN.com. We start off in Jones County. Multiple units responded to a heavily involved structure fire on Saturday. Southwood Volunteer Fire and Rescue says they responded to a structure fire along Burneytown Road as mutual aid to several Jones County units. A one-story residential home showed visible flames. While battling the blaze, the roof collapsed in. Fortunately, all firefighters were able to make it out of the building without injury. WITN is working to get more information on this fire, and we'll update you as more information on the story becomes available. The second annual Public Safety Weekend at Beaufort County Community College wrapped up on Sunday evening. After two full days of classes and hands-on training opportunities for firefighters, EMS crews, law enforcement officers, and 911 communications personnel. One training situation involved an LP gas tank, which is required for the nine members of the BCCC Fire Academy. The training also emphasized communication under pressure and working together. All Fire Academy students are volunteers at various fire departments in the East, and they say the training will allow them to spread the very valuable information. In addition to the Fire Academy students, other first responders from across the state attended to participate in classes and receive a variety of other certifications. And finally, authorities in New Hanover County say a Carolina Beach woman is accused of fleecing a dozen people hoping to adopt a child. District Attorney Ben David told local media outlets that 37-year-old Wendy George is charged with four counts of obtaining property by false pretenses. At a court hearing on Friday, her bail was raised from $25,000 to $500,000, $500,000. And David said George posted messages on various websites devoted to adoption and offered her services to people hoping to become parents. Investigators say at least 12 victims have come forward. In 2012, she was convicted of 16 counts of obtaining money by false pretenses after she and an accomplice took money from several people across the U.S. for vacation rentals in Carolina Beach that did not exist. No sorry, latest news headlines from WITN, WITN.com. Time up on this Monday, 8:38.
Thank you, Matty Ice. 22 in front of 9. Let's check some sports headlines now. With that, here's Trent McGee.
Yeah, big weekend for the ECU baseball team. The number 9 Pirates completed the sweep at the 14th annual Keith LeClair Classic Sunday afternoon with a 4-0 victory over Appalachian State. With the win, the Pirates improved to 8-3 on the season and extend their winning streak to 8 games. Freshman Trey Benton picked up his second win of the season. The Pirates back in action for a 2-game midweek series at College of Charleston, which starts tomorrow. ECU basketball, the Pirates closed out the regular season with a 73-51 loss at Houston. ECU returns to action on Thursday in the first round of the American Basketball Championship in Hartford, Connecticut. The Pirates take on Temple at 3:30. That game will be televised on ESPNU. UNC forward Justin Jackson was named the ACC Player of the Year Sunday. NC State guard Dennis Smith Jr. was named the Freshman of the Year, and Duke's Luke Kennard was the only player to earn unanimous first team All-ACC. And on the links, Dustin Johnson won the World Golf Championships Mexico Championship in Mexico City. He has now 14 PGA Tour wins and his 4 World Golf Championship titles, giving the most of anyone other than Tiger Woods. Brad Keselowski, also a winner on the track there in Atlanta.
So that Benton kid that's pitching for ECU, he's had two great outings.
He has.
He had eight, local Greenville kid?
West Columbus.
Oh, okay. For some reason, I thought maybe I knew his parents locally here. It must be a different Benton. Okay, that's a different kid than I thought it was. he's pitching so well that I'd say basically for him the ceiling is the roof.
It is.
I'm sorry.
It is.
Just beating it to death. All right, let's check the weather. Sunny and 64 today. We're looking for cloudy and 47 tonight, but warm weather all week long. Coming up on Tuesday night, some showers, but they're going to clear out by early morning hours on Wednesday, are they not, Matt?
Correct.
Pretty much.
Mm-hmm.
And then Wednesday is going to be pretty, too. Sunny and 68 degrees. Current temperature now 33 in Greenville. It's warming up and already 37 in New Bern. News and weather, a service this morning of the Tire Realty Group and Property Management Team. If you have a home you need to sell, there's only one number to remember, and it's HOME, 758-HOME. That's the number for the Tire Realty Group and Property Management Team. Remember all the reasons to list your home with Tire Realty. Number one, no upfront fees. Number two, they guarantee to sell your home in 99 days or they take no commission. And number three, which one of the biggest ones, that you can fire them at any time and pay them nothing. I'll even add another one. They do more marketing and advertising than anybody in the history of the real estate market here in Pitt County. So contact the Tire Realty Group right now, 758-HOME. List your home. They guarantee to sell it in 99 days. 758-HOME. That's 758-4663 or 99orfree.com. And by the way, if you're in the real estate business looking for a job, they're looking for you. They want to talk to you right now. They have a need for more agents. They got so many listings right now. So give them a call. All right, it's 19 in front of 9. Vivian Howard, the famous chef from The Chef and the Farmer, is going to do a banquet here. If you have not had a chance to meet Vivian yet, she's coming to do something here in Greenville, and it's going to be a real nice banquet featuring her. I'll tell you all about the details on that when we return. Stay with us.
During Greenville Toyota's vacation, put zero down and drive payment free for 3 months. Or drive Camrys, $16,990. Or Corollas, $14,999. Plus, get our advantage. Take a vacation with zero down and zero payments for 3 months. Visit GreenvilleToyota.com, where our volume saves you money.
My prescription refills.
My son's shot records.
My doctor's appointments.
My lab results.
My parents' care.
My chart.
Vidant My Chart.
Vidant My Chart is the secure online patient portal that lets you manage your health your way. Visit VidantMyChart.com or call 1-855-MyVidant to learn how you can sign up.
Dog Academy is Eastern North Carolina's complete dog training facility. Top Dog provides an excellent environment for dogs of all ages with training services and workweek daycare. Top Dog is located on Highway 43 South, just 4 miles from Bells Fork, and features a comfortable, healthy environment and a spacious facility for daycare and a brand new, beautiful facility for training. Call 752-8215 or visit topdogonline.com.
Come on out Highway 43 South to Top Dog Academy, where we know dogs.
To a great start to the year at the new Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram.
It's time for a new truck. Save up to $10,087 on select 2017 Ram 1500 Crew Cab trucks during Ram Truck Month. You can also save big with a Jeep Grand Cherokee lease. Drive a new Grand Cherokee for just $259 per month.
We're ready to serve you at the new Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram on Highway 264 and shop us online at WashingtonChrysler.com.
Cellular put towers where most others don't. So people can schedule a chiropractor visit out here. Or catch the game live way over here. Isn't that what you pay for? A stronger signal in the middle of anywhere.
Visit Real Wireless, your local U.S. Cellular authorized agent in Ahoskie, Williamston, and Windsor for the best deals in wireless and great service on a network that works in the middle of anywhere.
Buy with zero down today and do not pay for 3 months. Greenville Toyota wants you to take a paycation.
Get a new Toyota with zero down and make no payments for 3 months. Plus, get our advantage. Visit GreenvilleToyota.com, where our volume saves you money.
It's 8:45. Welcome back. Talk of the Town here on Monday morning. Good to have everybody with us this Monday. And coming up at the end of the month, if you have not had a chance to meet the famous Vivian Howard, she is going to be here in Greenville for a banquet, and you can attend. It's a simple matter of buying a ticket. It's all part of the spring banquet from the Friends of Joyner Library. And here from ECU to talk about that is my friend Rachel Becton, who works as a development officer for Joyner Library. How are you, Rachel?
I'm good. How are you?
Good to see you. Thank you for being in here this morning.
Thank you.
Vivian Howard, that's a good get for you guys, because I can tell you, we've tried to get her for our home show the last 2 years, and it's tough to get Vivian. And she just won a national, it's in today's paper, actually. She just won another national award for her cookbook. And, of course, we're talking about the famous owner of The Chef and the Farmer in Kinston, who has her own television show now on PBS for several years, A Chef's Life. Mm-hmm. And she's going to be here in Greenville on March 30th. Tell us all the details.
So you can purchase tickets through tinyurl.com/friendsbanquet. The event is going to be March 30th, which is a Thursday. It'll be at the Greenville Hilton. Tickets are $100, and they come with a book and dinner, or you can purchase a table for $1,000, and that gets you priority seating, 8 tickets, and 8 books.
And is she going to sign books? Or?
She will. The books will actually come pre-signed.
Oh, okay. So so the books will be signed.
They will already
you'll
be signed,
you'll get a copy of a signed book.
Correct.
I'm trying to pull up the thing I saw this morning. Of course, now I can't find it. But it was on the front page of the News and Observer website this morning. Oh, here it is right here. Here it is. Her book has just won a top industry award.
Oh, wow.
This is in this morning's News and Observer. The name of the book is Deep Run Roots, and it has just won Cookbook of the Year from the International Association of Culinary Professionals.
That's amazing. Another thing to add to why we're excited to have her.
Yeah, exactly. So, and you'll get a copy of the book, a signed copy of the book from Vivian Howard. And now, what's the format? It's dinner and a banquet, and so she's going to get up and do a talk and then take questions from the audience and stuff like that?
Exactly. So doors open at 5:30. Dinner starts at 6. We will have a presentation on our friends, what we do. We'll talk about our Lifetime Membership Award, that'll be to Edith Rand this year. And then Vivian will speak, and then we'll have a question-answer session.
Now, this group, Friends of Joyner Library, is a group that actually, and is what you do, is you help raise money for the library. And I was just in Joyner Library last week.
Oh, wonderful.
And, man, what an incredible. It's a lot different than it was when I was in school.
It's even different than when I was there, when I was a student.
really, really unbelievable research center, and I was actually up in the North Carolina Collection Room.
Oh, wonderful!
Which has some of the most amazing artifacts from North Carolina, and that room's not always open, is it?
It is for the most part, because students can go in there and check out books, but it's open definitely during our normal business hours.
But thank you for what you do
for
Joyner Library, because it's such a vital part of the university. And this is a great opportunity. Again, what a fun night coming up March 30th.
Yes, sir.
At the Greenville Hilton, you get a chance to meet the famous Vivian Howard from A Chef's Life.
Yes, sir. We'd love to have you come.
Give the ticket information slowly so people can write it down.
Okay. It is $100 a ticket, or $1,000 for a table, that can be purchased through tinyurl.com/friendsbanquet.
That's tiny as in small?
Tiny as
T-I-N-Y-U-R-L
in small.
tinyurl.com/friendsbanquet.
Friends Banquet. Right. Or they can call 328-4090, which is my number.
All right, great. Well, good luck with it.
Thank you so much. We're looking forward to it.
I hope it's a huge success.
We are too.
I know when Vivian speaks that people want to meet her, so that's a great opportunity coming up March 30th. Good to see you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. Rachel Becton from ECU. All right, it's 11 minutes now in front of 9. Be right back.
U.S. Cellular put towers where most others don't, so people can schedule a chiropractor visit out here. Or catch the game live, way over here. Isn't that what you pay for? A stronger signal in the middle of anywhere.
Visit Real Wireless, your local U.S. Cellular authorized agent in Ahoskie, Williamston, and Windsor for the best deals in wireless and great service on a network that works in the middle of anywhere.
It's a new year, and we're going to bring you the best offers on new cars and trucks here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
It's Ram Truck Month. Lease a 2017 Ram Crew Cab for $369 a month with no money down. Just sign and drive. No strings attached. Drive a new 2017 Jeep Grand Cherokee for just $259 per month. And come check out our entire lineup of new Jeeps.
East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Come see us.
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
North Carolina's complete dog training facility. Top Dog provides an excellent environment for dogs of all ages with training services and work week daycare. Top Dog is located on Highway 43 South, just 4 miles from Bells Fork, and features a comfortable, healthy environment and a spacious facility for daycare and a brand new, beautiful facility for training. Call 752-8215 or visit topdogonline.com.
Come on out Highway 43 South to Top Dog Academy, where we know dogs.
My prescription refills.
My son shot records.
My doctor's appointments.
My lab results.
My parents' care.
My chart.
Vidant My Chart.
Vidant My Chart is the secure online patient portal that lets you manage your health your way. Visit VidantMyChart.com or call 1-855-MyVidant to learn how you can sign up.
Talk of the Town at 8:52. Good tune, Michael. Level 42, one hit wonder. I actually saw this band perform that song in the, I think it was the late 80s in the Dean Dome. They opened for Tina Turner. And they were a great band, but they only had one hit. They never had another hit, did they?
That's correct. That's it. That's all they had.
Level 42. All right. 8:53 now, 7 minutes in front of 9 o'clock. Right, we are going to do the laugh track again by special request. Had a request at the home show that we should start doing the laugh track again in the 8 o'clock hour, that people in the 7 o'clock hour sometimes miss it, and so, you know, we should replay the laugh track. So on the days when we have time, we'll do that again, coming up in just a minute. But first, let me remind you about Suddenlink. It's time to get pumped because for a limited time when you sign up for Suddenlink's Triple Play, you get a $100 reward card. You get fast 50-meg internet, TV with up to 200 channels and phone service for just $77.99 a month. And you get a 30-day money-back guarantee, and you'll lock in this price for 2 years. And, of course, don't forget the $100 reward card. But you got to hurry because the deal ends soon. At Suddenlink, call 866-432-1184 today. Suddenlink, more power to you. Remember Suddenlink's high-speed internet? 8 times faster than internet from the phone company. If you don't have Suddenlink internet, you don't have fast internet. We use it here at the office. I use it at home, and it's the fastest. This offers for new residential customers. Restrictions do apply. See Suddenlink.com for details. Talk of the Town, again here this morning. We appreciate all the good stuff this morning. Appreciate Engelbrecht being here. We've had a very busy day today. A lot of stuff. Be interesting to see where this wiretap story goes today now that the National Review has come out with new details. Looks like the Russian narrative may be blowing up in the liberals' faces. We'll see. There was a big Trump rally in Raleigh on Saturday. I don't know if you saw that. People still campaigning for Trump, even though he's already there. And a lot of the legislative legal battles. Again, I was gone last week. Congratulations to Representative Greg Murphy. I know he was on with Tom on Thursday morning talking about his opioid bill, and what a great thing that is. So, and by the way, thanks to Tom Lamprecht and Billy Weaver for sitting in Thursday. I listened a little bit on TuneIn Radio in my hotel room, Michael. Sounds like they had a good show on Thursday.
Very good show.
And then Trent and Michael and Mark handled the all the stuff at the convention center Friday morning well as also. All right, let's do the laugh track again. Here's the laugh track replay from Dana Carvey this morning. There's the Talk of the Town laugh track.
I don't know. To me, I'm a boomer, but to me, you know, capitalism is an Apple store. Socialism is the Department of Motor Vehicles. And I love them Department of Motor Vehicles. Sweaty, pissed off workers that can't get fired, just yelling, and they laugh at you. You got in the wrong line, you f***ing idiot. Then you go to an Apple store, it's like a Stanley Kubrick film, you know. Welcome to the Apple store. Do you like all of our beautiful toys? Are you in the market for a 2017 fully loaded MacBook Pro with, wait for it, to 64 gigabytes of storage? Or would you like to visit the Genius Bar for some mental stimulation?
Dana Carvey, still one of my favorites from Saturday Night Live. Hey, don't forget, sports listeners, the Herd with Colin Cowherd debuts this afternoon, 3 o'clock on 94.3 The Game. Something new, our new lineup. See you tomorrow, everybody.
Buy with zero down today and do not pay for 3 months. Greenville Toyota wants you to take a paycation. Get a new Toyota with zero down and make no payments for 3 months. Plus, get our advantage. Visit GreenvilleToyota.com, where our volume saves you money.
It's a new year, and we're going to bring you the best offers on new cars and trucks here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep. It's the Start Something New event, and all 2016 Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram vehicles must go. Lease a new Jeep Grand Cherokee for only $239 a month, or lease a new Ram truck for only $299 a month. And if you buy now, you'll get 20% off select Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram. East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Let's see it.
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
My prescription refills.
My son shot records.
My doctor's appointments.
My lab results.
My parents care.
My chart.
Vidant My Chart.
Vidant My Chart is the secure online patient portal that lets you manage your health your way. Visit VidantMyChart.com or call 1-855-MyVidant to learn how you can sign up.
U.S. Cellular put towers where most others don't, so people can schedule a chiropractor visit out here, or catch the game live way over here. Isn't that what you pay for? A stronger signal in the middle of anywhere.
Visit Real Wireless, your local U.S. Cellular authorized agent in Ahoskie, Williamston, and Windsor for the best deals in wireless and great service on a network that works in the middle of anywhere.
During Greenville Toyota's vacation, put zero down and drive payment free for 3 months. Or drive Camrys, $16,990. Or Corollas, $14,999. Plus, get our advantage. Take a vacation with zero down and zero payments for 3 months. Visit GreenvilleToyota.com, where our volume saves you money.